U.S. Defense Secretary Chuck Hagel describes the U.S. strategy to fight ISIS in Iraq and Syria as a long-term one that begins with helping Iraq to become stable. Hagel talked about the strategy with journalist Charlie Rose. Hagel says U.S.-led airstrikes are helping Iraqi forces battle Islamic State group militants. He also reports that more U.S. special forces will help with the training of both Iraqi forces and the Kurdish Peshmerga. Joining us now with a Middle East wartime perspective on all this is Lieutenant General Rick Lynch. Welcome, General Lynch.
Hey, Mark. Thank you for the time.
Yeah, thank you for your time today and your insights. Secretary Hagel says part of the strategy is a stable Iraq. You served as a division commander during the surge in Iraq in 2007 and 8, and you have firsthand experience there. Is this achievable?
It is, but it, as Secretary Hagel said, it's going to take a long period of time. We were pretty close at the conclusion of the surge, creating a stable Iraq to allow them to pursue democracy in their own way. But when we came out of Iraq, candidly, relatively prematurely, it allowed the terrorists to reestablish foothold.
General Lynch, what are the different challenges that the U.S. and other forces face with a terror group like ISIS?
Well, they're just evil people. I mean, the major problem, candidly, when you're trying to protect the population, and that's what we're trying to do in Iraq now, is making sure that the population knows that you're going to be there for a period of time, because when you leave, the terrorists retaliate against the innocent civilians. So during the surge, we had enough troops on the ground so we could not only secure the area, but protect the population. And the Iraqi people would always come to my soldiers and ask two questions. They'd ask, are you going to stay? And when they were convinced we're going to stay, the question was, how can we help? That's how we turned our part of the area in Iraq that was formerly entitled the Triangle of Death to the Triangle of Life, because the Iraqi people stood up to protect themselves. But with terrorists, you have to take the fight to them. And oh, by the way, if you're not there and they have been hurt via airstrikes or whatever, they're going to take out their anger on the local population. So that's always a major concern.
Do you think the Obama administration and Congress need to be doing more to support the Kurds?
Well, you got to ask yourself in these situations, what are you trying to accomplish? And I believe what we as a nation are trying to accomplish in the Middle East is to secure the population and deny places like Iraq as a safe haven for terrorists. So we can't just walk away. I mean, if we do, then the terrorists are going to use that as a breeding ground. And then we as a nation are candidly going to be attacked again, much like we were on 9/11. Now, in my own personal view, based on my experience, the air power campaign is critical. It's necessary, but not sufficient. But to be able to do what needs to be done to secure the population and give the Iraqi people an opportunity to pursue freedoms in their own right, you have to have some boots on the ground.
What can you tell us about the threat of ISIS on American soil? I mean, could these terrorists penetrate our borders illegally, enter our nation?
Yeah, when I do public presentations these days, I tell people, if you slept well last night, you're not paying attention, because we're a nation at risk. These terrorists, they hate us and they hate our way of life. So we really have to be conscious all the time, not just in places like the Middle East, but here on our own U.S. soil, because those terrorists are out there. And the only way you keep them from attacking us on American soil is you take the fight to them in places like Iraq and Syria, those places.
Let's talk a little bit more about that. What do the American people need to understand about their way of thinking versus ours?
Well, first off, remember, the Iraqi people are good people. They're just like us. They just want freedom from fear. They want to be able to send their kids to school. They want to be able to provide for their families, those kinds of things. The terrorists, candidly, they're just evil people. And the only way you can take care of the evil people is to destroy those evil people. So it has to be a campaign of destruction. We have to target ISIS and take them off the battlefield. That's what we have to do. Now, candidly, you got to always remember that the military component is only a piece of the equation. A concern we had in Iraq all along, and candidly I still have today, is there has to be a government in Iraq that promotes unity between the Sunni population, the Shia population, and the Kurds. And if you don't get that, everything we do is for naught over time. So we got to continue to advocate that unity government in the government of Iraq.
All right, let's change topics here. You tell us about your book. It's called Adapt or Die, Leadership Principles from an American General. Captivating title there. What do you want readers to take away from it?
Well, I think we as a nation are struggling. We're struggling because we don't have adaptive leaders at all levels, from the national level all the way down to the community level. So what I did with the book is I took 35 years in the Army and 4 years at West Point, condensed it down to 9 leadership principles with a focus on faith and family. Because to turn our nation around, to get us back on the right track, we need leaders who do the right things for the right reasons. I always ask 3 questions. Are we doing the right things? Are we doing things right? What are we missing? And what I try to do in my book is to capture the essence of how to be an adaptive leader and to build adaptive organizations with focus on attitude, engagement, and time management. And I spend a lot of time talking about my personal faith and how God sees me through difficult times, like he promised in Joshua 1:9. When you look at the book, in appendix, you see the 9 leadership principles, but more importantly, you see my 15 go-to scriptures, those pieces of scripture that allow me to do what I need to do on a daily basis.
All right, and we're going to have information on how our audience can get the book with this story on our website. General Rick Lynch, thank you so much for your time and your insights. We really appreciate it.
Thank you, Mark. Take care.